Since her emergence from Toronto's indie music scene in the early 2000s, I got a man to stick it out and make a home from a rented house. Leslie Feist has been impressing critics and moving audiences. Take it slow, take it easy on me. Now, she's back with a new album. Wind and lightning, flashes flashing. This one heavily influenced by her roller coaster experience during the pandemic. There was the isolation we all felt, as well as the birth of her daughter and the death of her father. Multitudes is set to be released in full next week. Feist stopped by the CBC's Glenn Gould Theatre, where we had the chance to chat.
How are you? I'm David.
Congratulations on this new album. It's exquisite.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Really quite something. And you know, it has been a few years since you were out promoting an album.
Yes.
A lot has changed in the world in that time.
Yes.
In your own life, you've come through love, new life, and loss. Mm. What's it like now? How are you?
I'm all right. I'd say things look vaguely familiar. Everything, all the pieces fell back down, and I'm pretty pleased with the, it's sort of like the rigor of the life I'd built before the pandemic is sort of alive and well. It's holding us up.
And yet you are now on this new adventure of parenthood.
Yes.
Tell me about what it's like being a mom.
I mean, I've joked with friends that were parents before I was that I didn't realize this is what they were doing all along. I feel like I'm finding it a bigger adjustment and maybe more challenging than my friends. And they say, oh, what are you talking about? No, it's just that when I'd finally go out for dinner with my friend who didn't have kids like me before, I would be so glad to talk about everything else, you know. Yeah. But I didn't understand that, you know, that their worlds had been shifted so much and their responsibilities had, you know, mounted in their outlook probably and their empathy and their you know, the openness of their heart had shifted so much, because now that I'm in that state, I marvel that this is what the human race is based upon. It's just such a wild experience.
And that has to influence your work, your music, and into this new album.
It did kind of push, it pushed me into, I suppose, to try to locate myself inside the responsibility of being a parent and find semblance of a former self or some the pieces of a former self that would serve me in motherhood and as an artist. It was it kind of felt more important to take that time to continue to write and make sense of just such a crucible of love and responsibility.
You've unfortunately lost your dad.
Yes.
Did he have the opportunity to meet your child?
Yes. Yes, I'm so lucky that I had about a year and a half. My daughter had been born, and then lockdown occurred, and it was one of those double-edged swords. The world had such a misfortune. I mean, that's such an understatement. But in my own life, I managed to stay still. I spent those early months with my daughter, kind of the world was echoing what was happening with me anyway, which was being very closed in, and my arms were around her, and I was focused so fixedly on her. And then we had potted with my father because he was on his own, and it sort of felt like, okay, let's just try to make the best of this strange experience. And so there was, that was the advantage of, in a way, being forced
to
stop
still. It sounds oddly like a gift.
It was, because, I mean, we never know when it's, when someone dies suddenly, it's not, then every day before that, you can look at as, how did I not know what was coming? Because you don't know. And so it was a gift. It was, I was very lucky to be able to see her in his arms and feel kind of the medicine that a baby can be to anybody. Love is not a thing you try to do. It wants to be the thing compelling you. The tool that I use for my job is to encapsulate these big tectonic feelings and to try to make maybe unobscure them and make sense of a moment that is uncomfortable or that there's no solution for. There's no, maybe a song is another way to phrase a question that can't be answered, you know?
Sometimes we don't get to love who we are meant to.
Where do you get the stamina, the inspiration now? Where does that come from?
That's a good question. I guess it's just a language that I've been using for so long, this particular vocabulary of songwriting and what I believe it to be for or why I'm interested in continuing, what I'm looking for when I'm writing. That is the thing that gives me energy. You know, it's the thing that on an exhausted day with a, you know, a newborn over there in a little basket, finally asleep, why would I not use that moment to sleep, and why instead would I use that moment to try to, you know, give myself some sense of understanding of this moment.
She'll grow up into this, and she'll be able to go back like all kids can on YouTube or whatever the incarnation is the day, and she'll be able to see things like 1, 2, 3, 4, and mushroom.
Yeah.
1, 2, 3, 4, monsters walking across the floor. I love counting to the number 4.
Where's that in the context of your mind now?
It's so funny because, I mean, I've spent the years since the Sesame Street thing came out, you know, I can be in an airport, I can be just anywhere, it'll catch me by surprise. Someone with a toddler will say, you know, and usually the kid doesn't know who I am because they're busy looking at the puppets or whatever, but it is a part of me understanding raising a child. There's this repeating of things that the kid wants to see the same thing over and over or hear the same thing. But my daughter hadn't seen it, and the other day she walked into the room holding 4 bananas and she said, 1, 2, 7, 10 or something. And I said, oh, no, it's 1, 2, 3. And she went, 1, 2, 8, 9 or something. And I was like, no, well, it's 1, 2, 3. And then it literally dawned on me. I was like, I actually have something I can show you. I have something exactly for this to teach you about these 4 bananas, you know.
And suddenly you're best mom ever.
And I just, like, it's hilarious. She didn't even skip a beat. But it was, I know, I thought, well, this is, I'm having this moment where I'm realizing what it's been all along for the parents that have told me about this moment, you know.
Is this still as fun as it's always been?
Yeah, I would say it keeps...
Probably different.
It changes. It's. I mean, it is a gift to get to continue to do it. It is. It's all I know how to do. So, I mean, I'm lucky that I get to continue to do it. Yeah.
Well, we're lucky to get to hear it. Leslie, thanks so much for the conversation.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it.